Welcome back. The Reserve Bank has raised interest rates to 2.35%, its highest level in 7 years. Since May, rate increases have added almost $1,000 extra a month to a $750,000 mortgage.
To discuss, we're joined by Executive Chairman of Yellow Brick Road Home Loans, Mark Boris, and the Domain's National Editor, Alice Stoltz, in Melbourne. Mark, this is putting massive pressure on homeowners right now. How far will Philip Lowe go?
Well, it's designed to put pressure on homeowners. That's the whole point. That's the first thing. And the second thing is the general consensus in the market by one group of banks is saying it'll go to 2.6 by the end of this year. So in other words, another rate rise by the end of this year from 2.35 to 2.6. There's another group of banks are saying by February, March next year, it'll go to 3.25.
Wow.
So there's a bit of a difference in their opinions. Who knows, but just on that number you quoted, $1,000, if it goes to 2.6, you're going to be looking at another $1,200 a month.
Whoa.
If it goes to 3.25, that's the official rate, then you're going to be looking at close to $1,500 extra on a $750,000 loan. So okay. It's a big deal. And that's after tax dollars.
Sure.
Yeah.
Alice, talk us through the numbers with this latest increase, 50 basis points. How much is that going to increase Aussie mortgages or affect the average Aussie mortgage?
Good morning, guys. As Mark just referred to, if you've got a loan of around $750,000, you're now going to be paying an extra $1,000 a month. And I think we've seen this sort of this rate rise happen quite incrementally. And I think at the beginning, people were like, oh, a couple of $100 here or there can probably manage it. But now that we're getting into this sort of league, you're really going to start to people feel that pinch in every part of their life.
Yeah, so Mark, there's been a bit of discussion about how long it takes for these rate rises to actually hit the hip pocket. The same goes for the property market. It actually takes quite a while for this to flow through to buyers and sellers out there on the streets. So what are you thinking is going to happen in the property market? We've seen it go down a little bit already. Are those drops going to start increasing?
Well, the real estate agents I've been talking to are saying to me they're not seeing any distressed sales yet. And generally speaking, those where they pass in other words, they don't sell at auction, those properties have just been put on the market for sale. So in other words, vendors are not necessarily meeting the market, the buyer's expectations. But I think if we get two more rate rises by the end of this year and sometime February next year, because we have a break between January period, I think you'll start to see a little bit more pressure on vendors to meet the market around February next year.
So that's when you think we'll see more distressed sales?
Maybe not necessarily distress at this stage, but certainly willingness to meet the market.
Right, OK. It's a really nervous time for a lot of people. Alice, what is your advice to buyers and sellers right now?
I think when we talk about buyers, we need to ensure that they feel empowered. We're heading up to the spring selling season, so there is going to be increased options on the market. We also know that the other side of interest rates is that house prices are softened. So if you're buying and selling in the same market, you may well be selling for less than what you would have a year ago, but you'll also be able to buy for less. And I think it's also really important that buyers sort of get rid of this feeling of fear. We've all had, for years, we've had FOMO. People have bought because of fear of missing out. And now we have people being fearful of overpaying. And I think it's really important to do your research, look at what is happening in the market around you and the certain property types. And I'm talking as recently as 3 months ago, not looking at what sales were selling for a year ago. And actually do your research and feel quite empowered by that knowledge of what you should be offering when it comes to buying.
Yeah. And Alice, there's been a lot of talk about homeowners and fair enough, but what about renters? How do these dynamics affect people in the rental market?
Guys, unfortunately, this problem is really ebbing out into the rental market. We are experiencing a rental crisis at the moment. We've never had lower vacancy rates. All around the country, people are absolutely feeling the impact of these rising interest rates. Landlords are understandably, one could argue, passing these on to tenants. We also have a problem with supply. We do not have enough housing in this country at the moment. So the rental market is particularly grim, and that's even harder. It's putting more pressure on first home buyers who are being impacted by rising rates are also now having to pay higher rents as well.
Mark, what would be your advice to those who are concerned about meeting their mortgage repayments at the moment? What should they do? What are their options?
Well, I mean, if you're really in distress period, contact your lender and seek an abatement for 3 months. Most contracts, mortgage contracts, allow you to ask your lender to give you an abatement. In other words, no payments for three months, but you're going to have to prove you're in that sort of financial situation. Other than that, if you're going okay, what you've got to do is go to a mortgage broker or something like someone like that and say, how can I get a better rate? This is about rate hunting right now. And rate hunting is a really important thing. You need to know what interest rate I'm paying. Most people don't know their interest rate within a three-month period after settling their loan. What is my interest rate? What is it relative to everyone else's rate in the marketplace? And how can I get a cheaper repayment system? And go see a broker. The broker will do it for you for nothing, cost you nothing. He'll do all the work for you, or she'll do all the work for you. And if it works, it works. And sometimes you can get cash back. Some of the lenders will give you cash back.
Because a lot of banks will offer you a reduction on your rate if you're a new customer too. So
correct.
It's worth shopping around, isn't it?
Correct. Shop around.
Thank you, Mark, and thank you, Alice. We appreciate you both coming in today.
Thank